Welcome to the Be Pumped Podcast, where we will help you become focused on your goals with faith, covenants, and progress. And now your host, Malin Lewis. Get ready to be pumped up.
Yo, what up, guys? This is episode number four, número cuatro, para toda la gente que habla en español. Bienvenidos. Welcome, everybody. This is episode number four. Super pumped. Obviously, you guys know the BYP Pump Podcast. We are here to help with your business, your life, your relationship, and bring you that content to be able to help you level up, right? We're motivated and inspiring others to be able to level up their life. I've been inspired for the past 10 to 15 years to level up my life, and little by little, I've been able to apply these certain things into my life to be able to bless those that are around me, right? So, a couple things here. The podcast, it's getting viewed. Super proud. If you guys can give me 5-star if you love it. If you don't love it, then give me a 1-star. I get it. But hey, 5-star would be great. I love you guys. Seriously, you guys are giving me great feedback, giving me tips, ideas of what you want to hear, who you want me to bring on to the BYP Pump Podcast, BYP Nation. You guys are amazing. So a couple things today. Let me get started here. So I want to talk about 5 ways to stop being tired, okay? How many of you guys get tired out there? How many of you guys wake up, you're frustrated, you're not excited, you're not motivated, and you're not sure what you're going to be doing that day? So here's a couple tips that I feel like would be able to bless you guys and be able to help you level up in your ways, because getting up early is powerful, right? But here's 5 ways to stop being tired. So number one, go to bed and wake up at the same time. Now, this is hard. Believe me, this is super hard as I start to get these businesses building up right now. And I'm working late nights, early mornings. You know, especially if you've got a job or school, then you already have to get up early. If you also want to work on yourself at the same start of the day, that means you're going to need to get up even earlier. So when we sleep, we go through sleep cycles, right? Each sleep cycle is probably about, 90 minutes? And obviously, it's not perfect silence. So if you go to bed every day at midnight and wake up at 7 a.m., your body will naturally start to end its sleep, you know, like its final cycle at 7, because it knows that you're going to be getting up. So you got to create that pattern of going to bed, waking up at the same time. It's critical. It really, really is. If instead, you know, you're waking up at 5 one day and then 7 a.m. the next, and then the next, you know, and then you get up at 11 a.m. on the weekend, well, your body will have no idea what to do and you're gonna be tired. That's just, you know, that's just the gist of it. That's just how it's gonna have to happen. But so, remember, go to bed. Number one is go to bed and wake up at the same time. Start to create that cycle. You know, even if you are going to stay up late, we'll go to bed at that late time every night. Wake up at the same time. Here's number two. Have a wind down ritual. How many of you guys have a wind down ritual right now? Not too many do. I learned from, is it Tim Ferriss from the 4-Hour Workweek? That's a big thing that he does. He does rituals. Okay, so one reason that we get tired is because we stay up too late. So that's me. That's typically me. I'm really tired. So sometimes even like late at night at 9, 10 p.m., you know, we're doing things like checking email, you know, editing videos, or doing a YouTube channel, checking social media, or maybe just visiting with your wife, your spouse, your significant other. You know, we're just kind of passing the time rather than really focusing on our wind down ritual. So you got to find out what works best for you. Okay, so the simple thing is to do like a light, you know, maybe like a light blue light or maybe a dim light for maybe 90 minutes before bed. Okay, they say the blue light that is emitted from your phone and computer screen. So blue light tells your body that it's still daytime and can trick your, what do they call it, that circadian rhythm. It's what makes you tired and wakes you up and makes you extremely difficult to wake up. So find that wind down ritual for about 90 minutes before you go to bed. So you gotta limit that blue light exposure, right? So you, yeah, limit the blue light exposure, which is computers, your phones, so that way your body can wind down. So 90 minutes before you get, put it all away. Put it away and create that ritual, okay? Number three, get more sunlight. Get out in the sun. For those of us out here in Arizona, we love the sun. It really does make a difference. This one, you know, it's really kind of a small thing, but makes a difference. For those of you up in Seattle or those that are getting lots of rain in different parts of the country or even parts of the world, you guys got to get out in the sun. So simply going outside and getting a little bit of the sun, it will immediately wake you up. So it tells your body that it's daytime and your body responds accordingly, right? Okay, so more sunlight. So we're going back through it real quick. Go to bed, wake up at the same time is number one. So go to bed and wake up at the same time, number one. Number two, have a wind down ritual. Okay, number three is get more sunlight. Now it leads us to number four, hydrate, hydrate, hydrate. H2O people, get that big water, get that big metal, you know, what do they call those, hydro flask or big water bottles that you guys are taking around with you. And guess what, if you go into these convenience stores or if you're going and you're traveling, guess what, water's free. Get that ice, okay? That's one of the reasons that you could be groggy is that you're dehydrated, so you gotta hydrate. This is especially probably the, you know, really, really important is you need to have water right first thing in the morning, okay? You also have to realize that you just went 7+ hours without water. So you got to replenish your body and your mind because it won't be functioning at 100%. So if you don't do it, if you don't replenish it with water, your body and mind won't function 100%. So got to hydrate yourself. Drink that water, 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 water. It's definitely a game changer. So hydrate yourself. Number five, exercise. Me being big guy, over 300 pounds right now, I'm on a journey. Okay, I'm trying to change up my lifestyle. I'm trying to eat clean, drink that water, do journal every day. You know, I'm trying to meditate, do my workouts all the time. You know, that's just something that I do. And so you gotta just focus on, exercising, because, you know, exercising, think about this, even just simply as jumping on a small trampoline, okay, doing a few push-ups or some sort of active stretch will wake you up. So you'll get the blood flowing, get it to your mind, right? And your body will realize that it's not time to be asleep anymore. So this is extremely, extremely important. So let me run through them again. Top five ways to stop being tired. Number one, go to bed, wake up at the same time. Number two, have a wind down ritual. Okay. Number three, get more sunlight. Get that sun on you. Number four, hydrate, hydrate, hydrate. Get that water inside you. And then number five, exercise. Get going, guys. Get up in the morning and get going, whether it's your running or, like I said, jumping jacks. You got to do it. So hopefully these tips help so that you're not as tired during the day. Keep your bodies moving. Keep them sharp. Get out your journals. Write. Dedicate some time to reading scripture, reading good books, and seek that knowledge to be able to help you level up in your life. Be ye pumped. We're all about faith, making covenants, and progress, you guys. Keep that progress going. Even if it's just a little bit each day, it will help you gain that confidence to take you to that next level, you want to be able to walk into a room and own it. You want to be able to walk into that room with 100% confidence and focus and the ability to be able to shake people's hands, give them a hug, talk to them, get to know them, and help them level up as well. They'll want to be around you because of your confidence. And you won't be as tired because you'll be following these tips, right? You guys, seriously, never quit. Remember why you're doing this. Stay focused and be ye pumped. I'm out. Everyone have a great day, great weekend. And I'll just leave this with you. Stay disciplined, right? Be dangerous, but disciplined. Okay, I'm out. Hey, are you guys still there? Oh, yeah. I hope you guys have enjoyed this podcast. It's something that it's really deep to me. I appreciate everyone again for all that you're doing. It's really, really been helpful to know what you're looking for, how I can help you, and appreciate all the emails. Again, you can email me at beyepumped@gmail.com. You can follow me on Instagram, malin.lewis on Instagram. Sorry, I got it all mixed up. Or you go to BYP, DM me. Seriously, these are all out there for you guys to help you. And hopefully you have the mindset to help you motivate and level up to the next level. And anyways, that's all I got for you. And have a good one, guys.